question what you know. The seat you have picked will be yours for the next 9 months of your life. And those of you in the front row, beware. The law is reason free from passion. Does anyone know who spoke those immortal words?
David Kinney raises his hand.
Yes.
Aristotle.
Professor Stromwell walks very close to David Kinney.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Be willing to stake your life on it.
I think so.
What about his life?
Professor Stromwell hits another student on the head. Because that's allowed.
I don't know.
Well, I recommend knowing before speaking. The law leaves much room for interpretation, but very little for self-doubt. And you were right. It was Aristotle. Now, I assume all of you have read pages 1 through 48 and are now well-versed in subject matter jurisdiction. Who can tell us about Gordon versus Steele? Let's call on someone from the hot zone.
Professor Stromwell walks very close to Al. Al is busy dealing with her notebook. She's even noticed.
Al Wood.
Actually, I wasn't aware that we had an assignment.
Oh. Vivian Kensington.
Professor Stromwell glides over to Vivian.
Drink. Do you think it's acceptable that Ms. Woods is not prepared?
Elle turns to Vivian, bobbling her head, tossing her hair, and smiling.
No.
Elle stops smiling.
I don't.
Would you support my decision to ask her to leave class and to return home? To
Absolutely.
Now, Ms. Kensington, did diversity jurisdiction exist in this case?
No, it did not.
Good. How about in the case of Owens versus McCullough?
We'll never know.